loves a flame. Fire that burns, wind and rain. I don't care what anybody says. Everyone's always making fun of me because I like Michael Bolton. But you guys are sleeping on him. His Time Love and Tenderness album sold like 20 million albums. I know there's some men in that group. Every dime, every mission issue is always like, nah, I'm good. I'm that. But I'm like, I know there's men in that group because there's no way 20 million women bought that. But you never know because the boy bands and all that sell a lot of albums to little teenage girls. But I don't think it's all just women buying Michael Bolton's albums, honestly. Okay.
Feel inside. Said I love you, but I'm wrong. Cause love can never ever feel so strong.
You know what I like about this song is that it's like he's saying, like when I was younger and it was out and everything, I didn't understand what he meant. I remember I was talking to this girl and she's like, we were both like listening to it and we were like, oh yeah, I love this song, this and that. And then later I was listening to it and it made sense. I was like, oh, he's saying, because I was like, what is he talking about? He's lying. He told her he'd love her, but he lied. And then he's saying, I would like, he loves her more than words. I don't know. He's saying, I say I love you, but I lie because I love you is stronger than that, you know? Like, love doesn't like feel like fully describe it, kind of thing. And I remember thinking it was so cool because that, like, maybe a few years before he did this song, my parents took us to the Grand Canyon, and so. Just seeing him, because that's where that video is filmed, is at the Grand Canyon. And I remember thinking, like, oh my god, because, like, we had just been there, and how I was all scared just being there, because being, thinking I was gonna fall and stuff. So it was just cool that he did the video there, and how it like, fit with what he's singing, because, like, they had horses in it, and it was just, like, I don't know. I really like this song. This is, like, one of my favorite Michael Bolton songs. Okay, Time, Love, and Tenderness, I think, just stands on its own, that album, so I don't want to, like, put that in, but I like, How Am I Supposed to Live Without You, Said I Love You, But I Lied, Completely, Steel Bar is not Tenderness, Soul of My Soul. Then he kind of, like, faded out after that, like, he hasn't really been doing much, like, I mean, I'm not saying that, like, hating-wise. I'm just saying he hasn't... His heyday was, like, in the 90s. But he hasn't really released much since the 90s. Like, his royalties and everything from those 90s albums probably just... That's what he's living off of. Like, you know? He probably still got work. He's just, like, producing and stuff. But he doesn't have to really put no more albums out because he's already...
I love you, but I lie. It's more than love I feel inside. Said I love you, but I'm wrong.
Okay, I'm gonna ground up this meat a little more.
Said I love you, but I feel inside.
But alive. Okay, so I'm gonna mix. I don't know if I should start simmering the sauce. I'm thinking if I should simmer the sauce first, or because the sauce is already cooked, or it's already blended and everything. I'm not like making sauce from scratch. Okay, I love this song. This is off Soul Provider, and like, I remember I was watching the video for Soul Provider, and somebody, a guy, put a comment, oh my god, I only listen to like hard rock, and like, I love this song, and I'm like, he's funny. He's like, a lot of dudes try to be doing the most, and they say they don't like him. Okay, let me see how this tastes again. This cookie went last tasted again. This is gonna be a real meaty sauce. Oh, whoa. It's a no-win situation. Okay. Let me get the water ready. I'm gonna boil these noodles. Okay, how big of a pop do I need for this? Chicken enchilada pasta. I thought it's at my ancestor, so we'll see. Okay, gotta put the salt in the water, like Amber Elf is. Why is this like? Tenderness. Okay. Ooh, it even tells you like how much to take out of the box based on like how many serving. Mm-hmm.
So why say you say trying? Leave the house okay? For myself, nothing is as bad as it seems, you know. Cause someday you'll have to go there. But put you to the fire, but put you to the test. Nothing feels all broken heart like time, love, and tenderness. Baby, just remember this.
I remember my mom got me a Michael Bolton shirt. I guess it was like from this concert. And it was at a thrift store. And I was wearing it once, and this guy was like, I never thought I'd see the day that a sister would be wearing a Michael Bolton shirt. I was like at a bus stop, and this guy was like, he came over, and I'm like, he was like, I never thought I was gay. And I was just like, expand your mind, brother. To make it better. Okay, I hope that water is done. I need to get this quick baking already. I love that I can listen to all genres of music, like rap. I was listening to a big shine in Nicki Minaj earlier. And then House of Pain, and then Ramen Thick, all that. And then you can go from that to this, you know, and then to this, to like the Four Tops, rap, anything, you know. The only thing I'm not really crazy about is country. There's some songs, I guess, more the poppy ones, but for the most part, I just don't. And I remember someone who tried to get me into, I forgot the genre, but he was like, I remember we were in my car and I was playing Bon Jovi. And he was like, I like all this music. It was out when I was young, but he's like, this is all that, the commercial music. He's like, I like stuff that's more not popular. And I forgot what the genre was, but he put it on my phone, like, he went on Spotify, and it was, like, some kind of, like, was it goth? I don't even know what it was. It was something in the 80s, but it had a real 80s vibe to it, and I liked it. And I forgot what it was, but, yeah, I was, like, I'm one of those people, I think I could, like, listen to things, and I'm, like, okay, I like it. Is it, like, when he plays in the car type vibe? I don't know, but I like it enough at the time, you know. But for a long time, I didn't really, like, rap that much either, and then I got into it. Time, baby, on me. Okay, noodles almost done. Okay, I'm gonna cut this off right now. I'm waiting for my noodles to boil. And I was mad that those other noodles didn't work out, because those cooked in 6 minutes. Like, they cooked really fast, because it's been awesome. And I don't know how long this takes to cook, but hopefully it's not one of those, like, I like that it's pot size, and not, you know, big stocks in it. Oh, 8 to 9 minutes, so yeah, it takes a little longer. To be with you. I think he remade this song. I think the Bee Gees did this song, but I never heard the Bee Gees. But I just know it's a remake. If I don't have you, if I don't. To have somebody, the way I love you. What is it called? Alexa, skip. I see your face again. Okay, let me turn it off now. Alexa, stop. All right, you guys, I'm gonna put the noodles in. I'll be back. Bye. Hey everyone, so I sprayed my pan. I'm going to be putting this in the oven. I have my cheese, Italian style blend, 6 cheese blend, mozzarella, provolone, Asiago, Parmesan, Romano, and Fontina cheese. I mixed my sauce and and sausage all in this bowl. And then I'm gonna start layering in this baking pan. So I'm gonna take one layer. One layer of the noodles and meat. I kind of want to make that thing I made. I made a video about it before. It's the chicken enchilada. I called it chicken enchilada lasagna. This is kind of reminding me of that, except it's like with that you put tortillas and then you alternate like the chicken and cheese and seasonings and all that. Or the seasoning, everything's already mixed, but you just alternate tortillas, cheese, chicken mixture. And okay, so one layer down. Here's soda that I'm gonna move. I'm now gonna put cheese. I don't want the hunk of cheese in my mouth, so I'm just going to be very liberal or conservative. What is it called? Very restrained, I guess I would say, with how much I put in each layer. That kind of reminds me of like olive garden right there, like just how they would sprinkle it. All the sausage is like, now I'm not doing a like spaghetti bake per se, like I'm not doing it where I'm putting the egg and all that to keep it all mounded together. I'm just doing it basically to melt the cheese in between the layers and make it kind of just like cheesy spaghetti, because that's kind of like what I'm in the mood for, not like the full on. Because there was a few recipes online where they were saying like, but put egg in it to mound it, kind of like the with lasagna. Some people put egg, some people don't. Some people put you know, it's a personal preference thing. Okay, here's how it looks. Woo! It's gonna fall over. Alright, so I'm gonna put this in the oven. And now the problem is a lot of the sausage. Let me get a lot of that in there. It caught up in this bowl on the bottom. So let me make sure I got like a lot of that in here. One more thing of cheese. I'm doing this kind of in the style of, there's this frozen brand I like, Italian brand I like. It's called Michelangelo. And they put, now I want to turn this up. I'm going to turn this up a notch. I'm gonna put a piece of white what's that cheese called?
Extra sharp white. I like that flavor.
I got cracker pits because these are for my my crackers in ham, but I'm just gonna break a few of these up because they only at Aldi they only have the they only have the little box of cheese in regular white sharp. And extra sharp has another like dimension to it. Okay. I should have done this before I like finished the layers. But I'm gonna mix it all up when it's done. Melting. I'm probably going to put this on for about, I want it to get kind of like a burnt to it, but not burnt, like, to the extent where it's, like, not, where you can taste, like, the nasty bitterness. I'm talking about, like, burnt, like, ooh. Okay, so, I'm going to put this in the oven for about, maybe 15 minutes. Keep an eye on it. And here's how it looks. And I will be back when it comes out. Alright, bye. Okay, so the sketti is done. This is supposed to go in the refrigerator. And the cheese is all in it. It's just once it's like warmed up and everything, it'll be really good. And then with the parmesan cheese on it, of course. So yeah, you guys, I got a little dinner or lunch or whatever for the next day. All right. I will talk to you guys later. I'm gonna go cool down. All right, bye.